ho, ho! Welcome one and all to this video where we're going to show you how you can take one of your miniatures and place it inside a festive Christmas bauble to hang on your tree, while still being able to take that miniature out to play games with. Now, the first thing you need to get hold of is one of these. This is a fillable Christmas bauble ornament which we got from a local craft shop, but they are available in other places too. Once you've got one of these, the first thing we're going to be doing is applying a slot onto the bottom of the base using a spare apocalypse movement tray. Now, the model we're going to put inside our bauble is this festively painted Jakob Bugnsson miniature. He's got a 32mm base, so we have a spare 32mm apocalypse movement tray. Here's what we're going to do. What we're looking to do here is simply take one of these slots away from the base by cutting it away. That one on the end there is going to be the easiest one to do. So let's take a pair of fine detail cutters like this and very carefully snip around like so, just cutting into the base like this, all the way across. It'll crack across, that's not a problem. What we're going to do here is cut away all around like this, leaving a lip if you want to, and once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. There we go, that's the slots cut out from the movement tray. You can see there's a small lip here on the side, but that's not a problem, we'll disguise that later on. Okay, up next, let's stick that now into the bottom of our bauble using some super glue. Now I've turned it upside down here, and now we're going to be applying some super glue all over the bottom of it like so, just applying it nice and evenly around the edge of the slots like this, so all the way around. There we go, that's perfect. A nice generous amount. Bingo. Then, what we're going to do here is apply it into the bottom of our bauble here, just making sure it's sticking down, bottom down like so, and we're also going to apply it over to one side like this, so it's slightly off centre, as later on we're going to put some decoration in the back left-hand corner. But there we go, once that's stuck down, it's then time for us to move on to the next stage. There we go, that's the slot stuck in the bottom of the bauble. Now it's time for the next phase. Okay, up next, let's create a nice even flat layer on the bottom of our bauble by using a generic ready-mixed interior filler. This is the kind of stuff you can get from just about any DIY or hardware store. And to apply it, we're going to be using our trusty Citadel texture tool. Let's take some filler from the pot here and load it up onto our tool like so. There we go, nice big amount, perfect. Then, onto our bauble. Here, we're going to be filling in the area around the bottom here, making sure we're just creating a nice even flat surface at the bottom around where the slot is. We've got a water pot here so we can wet the tool to make it a little bit easier to make that a bit more malleable. We're going to work it all the way around like so until we've got a nice even flat bottom like so. So it's in line with the top of that slot. This is going to take quite a long time to dry once it's done, about 24 hours. So leave it on the side, be patient. Once it's done, it'll look great. There we go, we've applied the filler all inside the base to create that nice level. You can see we've left that slot free for the miniature later on, and now it'll need 24 hours to fully dry. But we haven't got to wait, because here's one I made earlier. There we go, this one's been fully filled in, and the filler has dried. So now it's time to move on to the next stage. Right, up next, let's apply some texture to the top of that filler to make it look like ground. And here we'll be using Stirling mud, and for this, grab your texture tool again. Take some Stirling mud from the pot like so and apply it onto the top of your texture tool like this on the fatter of the two ends. Then inside the bauble, here we're applying this as you would on normally on a base like so. Just applying it all round the top here like this, all round where you've put the filler in. Now be super careful here, not hit the slot or the side of the plastic. So when you get near either of them, just flip that tool round and use the thin end for a bit of extra control. Leave this for about an hour to fully dry, and once it has, it'll be time to move on to the next stage. There we go, the Stirling mud has dried. Okay, up next, let's fill in that slot in the middle with some Rhinox hides to help neaten it up. Grab your medium base brush for this. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Just gonna load our brush up like so, and then onto our bauble. Here, we're simply going to be painting it into the middle like so, and just covering up this slot in the middle. Now, if you go over the edges and hit the Stirling mud, that's not a problem, but make sure you get a nice solid coat on the inside of this. You may need a couple of coats to get a really strong color. There we go, that's the slots painted in. Okay, up next, let's dry brush over the top of that Stirling mud with a couple of colours. First, Steel Legion Drab, and then Carrick Stone. For both of these, grab your small dry brush. Let's take some Steel Legion Drab from the pot and onto our piece of tissue paper here. Now I'm going to work off most of this into the tissue paper, like so. Get rid of almost all of it. There we go, perfect. Then onto the bauble. Here, we're just going to dry brush all over the Stirling mud at the top, like so. You can see the lighter areas being picked out like this. Just very carefully dry brush over the top like this, working all the way around. Try as hard as you can here not to hit the sides of the bauble. Just be as neat as you can and just hit the Stirling mud. Up next, we're applying a second dry brush, this time of carrot stone. Again, applied all over the top where we put the sterling mud. There we go, that's those dry brushes done. Let's add some more texture into our bauble now with a few tufts. Now these are the Midland Tuft Set from Games Workshop, and when they arrive they come in this plastic backing. To remove and apply the tufts, simply grab your pair of Citadel fine detail cutters. What we're going to do here is take one of the tufts off of the backing like so, just by pulling it off with the cutters. Then into the bauble, what we're going to do here is to apply it in there like so and press it down. It's self-adhesive, so we're going to apply it just about there like that. Now you can apply as many as you like. I'm going to add quite a few around here to make it look quite tufty. There we go, that's the tuft applied. Now you can also see here at the back of the bauble, we've actually bored a small hole down into the filler. We used a paperclip to create that. And the reason we've done that is so we can now attach a small Christmas tree onto the back of our bauble. This Christmas tree here has come from a local craft shop, the same one we got the bauble from. It comes with a small wire coming out the bottom of it, and we're going to super glue that wire now into the hole we've just made. Let's grab some super glue here, just apply it to the wire that's coming out the bottom like so, nice healthy amount. Perfect. Then we're going to take the small Christmas tree and the bauble and just now apply it into that hole we just made like so. Just press it in like that, stand it up and let that super glue dry. There we go, the Christmas tree is in place, looking super festive. But not quite festive enough. Let's cover the whole bauble in snow. And of course for this, we're going to be using Valhalla Blizzard. Again, grab your medium texture tool for this. Let's take some Valhalla Blizzard from the pot and load up our texture tool like so. There we go, nice big amount like this. Then onto the bauble. Here, we're applying this now onto the based area around the slot, as thick as you like. You can either apply it all over, like I'm going to, make a nice deep and crisp and even layer, or you can have small patches wherever you want to. Just apply it all over to spread it on, much like icing or butter. I'm also going to place a little bit of snow on the tree here as well to help match that in with the base. It'll take about an hour to dry, and once it has, that'll be the bauble complete. There we go, with the snow effect complete and a ribbon on top to attach it to the tree, our bauble is done. There we go, that's how you can create a festive Christmas bauble for your miniatures. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Merry Christmas and happy painting. Thank you.